Hey everybody, it's Reverend Sal back for another Coffee with the Chaplain, my Starbucks. Maybe I can get them to advertise as if. Anyway, back for another episode of Coffee with the Chaplain as I clean my hands. Thought I'd come to you today with another episode. Quick or not. About a couple things. I want to do this first. First little PSA. Hydrate. Hydration. Make sure you're drinking lots of fluids. You got to be careful with the coffee because this is the one fluid that makes you lose fluid, if you know what I mean. It's a diuretic. So yes, while it's keeping you hydrated, it is actually making you evacuate the liquid. Is that too much information? Probably. So drink. Drink lots of water, drink lots of juice. Try to drink stuff that keeps you hydrated. Pedialyte, Gatorade, that type of stuff that keeps seltzer, a little bit of salt in it, just so you're absorbing it. Coffee too. Coffee does count as hydration. You want to be careful with coffee because you tend to pee it out. Anyway, hydrate. Make sure you're drinking. Especially now, if you notice my coffee cup, I don't know if you can see, it's sweating because it's humid. We're getting into late spring, early summer. Heat's going up. You're going to need fluid. Other thing I wanted to talk to you about is communication. Communication. Or lack thereof. Or bad communication. You'd be surprised how much, whether we realize it or not, communication is important. How we talk to each other, especially in a workplace or in a church or any sort of place where you have to do things together, communication is important, has to be effective. I think we, nowadays, we see bad communication because I think in a larger sense, in a macro sense, we're so busy waiting for our turn to talk that we're not listening. We might be listening for that person to stop talking so that we can start talking, but we're not actually listening to what's being said. And I see that on a macro level, on a big level in society. Just turn on the news. Go on social media, you see people yelling and screaming and yelling and screaming because no one's actually listening to each other. Where I see that in a more localized sense in our community or in a church or in a social club is, or in families, tough topics will come up. Stuff that needs to be discussed, and multiple sides will speak their mind, but we're not actually acknowledging what the other person is saying. Here, take a look at this clip from Monty Python and the Holy Grail.
Guards! Make sure the prince doesn't leave this room until I come and get him. Not to leave the room, even if you come and get him. No. Until I come and get him. Until you come and get him, we're not to enter the room. No. You stay in the room and make sure he doesn't leave. And you'll come and get him.
Yes.
Right. We don't need to do anything apart from just stop him entering the room.
No. Leaving the room.
Leaving the room, yes.
All right?
Right. Oh,
look, it's quite simple. You just stay here. I'll make sure he doesn't leave the room. All right?
Oh, I remember. Can he leave the room with us?
No. You just keep him in here. I'll make sure.
Oh, yes, we'll keep him in here, obviously. But if he had to leave, and we will with him...
Just keep him in here.
Until you or anyone else...
No, not anyone else, just me.
Just you.
Get back.
Right, we'll stay here until you get back.
And make sure he doesn't leave.
What?
Make sure he doesn't leave.
The prince?
Yes, make sure he doesn't leave.
Oh, yes, of course. I thought you meant him. You know, it seemed a bit daft me having to guard him when he's a guard.
Is that clear?
Oh, quite clear. No problems.
Right. Where are you going?
We're coming with you.
No, I want you to stay here and make sure he doesn't leave.
Oh, I see. Right.
But father...
Shut your noise, you, and get that suit on. And no singing. Oh, go and get a glass of water.
So we don't listen to what's being said to us. One tip that I learned in my chaplaincy training is to, and this helps with my visits when I visit people, if someone says to me, the dog walked down the street and it got off its leash, I will repeat what they said. I will say, so let me just make sure I heard you correctly. The dog went down the street and got off its leash. Or the person will say, I'm doing okay, but my wife yelled at me today. Most people, if you're not in the mode to communicate, will say, oh, he's doing okay. Great, they're doing okay. See you later. But my wife yelled at me today. Had you responded to, I heard you say you're okay, but your wife yelled at you. Can you expand on that a little bit? That then gives the person the acknowledgement that, okay, he actually heard what I just said and cares about what I'm saying and isn't just gonna say, okay, you're doing fine, see you later. When we communicate,
healthcare,
we do it in multiple ways. We do it with our mouths, we do it with our ears, we do it with our eyes, we do it with our face. So you may be listening, but if your eyes are over there or on your phone, or if you don't repeat back what the person says to you, you're not communicating effectively. So be aware of how you communicate with people. How you listen, how you respond, and what your body language, what your face, what your eyes are telling that person as you listen. Because you would want someone to listen to you as much as we want to be heard. Everybody wants to be heard. Be acknowledged is to be heard. I think a lot of our issues as humans, a lot of our anxiety, our doubts, our confidence, a whole gamut of issues in this world could be addressed if we all felt acknowledged and heard. So let me end real quick with some scripture from James 1. It says, you must understand this, my beloved. Let everyone be quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to anger. So, before you respond, listen. Go back to my three doorways of communication. Is it true? Is it nice? And is it necessary? The three gatekeepers of speech. Is it true?
AL plus dial zero.
No, we're not going to dial zero. Is it true? Is it nice? Is it necessary? Those are the three gatekeepers. All right, guys. I've been rambling on a bit, so I've spoken. I hope you hear me. If you do, let me know. This has been another episode of coffee talk. Remember, drink, drink, drink. Make sure you're hydrated. All right, guys, don't be a jerk and
be excellent to each other.
We'll see you next time.
This is uncharted territory. So let love be the compass.